those down for others to fill out. A few other activities going on. Today at 6 o'clock, there'll be a community Thanksgiving service at First Baptist Church. A group of churches are getting together to have a community service for Thanksgiving, so you're invited to join us there at 6 o'clock. And there'll be a time of fellowship afterwards. I'm told they're preparing a pie, so if you want to join us for worship and stick around for pie, we'll look forward to seeing you there. Inside the bulletin, there's lots of inserts and announcements. I'm going to highlight a few. We're going to have a special event on Saturday, December 1st. As we were kind of upgrading our membership list and everything this year, we realized we have an abundance of people in our midst who have reached 90 years of age or older, and are still very involved and active in the church. So we decided to have a celebration we're calling Bless the Years, in which we will honor those people, and we invite you to join us as well. For that, we'll have a short little worship service and then a dinner afterwards here in the parlor. So if you want to attend, just let the office know that you're coming so we can kind of have a rough estimate of who to prepare for, and we hope to see you there. The prayer calendars for daily prayer and scripture focus through the end of the year, there's some on the table right here in the back and also by the office if you'd want to pick those up. Every day has a scripture and a prayer focus that we will be in prayer together as a congregation until the end of the year. Inside, you notice there's a poinsettia order form. It's hard to believe, but it's time to start thinking about that. We will take orders through December 9th. If you just fill out that form and bring that and your payment to the office, we will get those ordered, and they'll be here for a couple Sundays during Advent and then Christmas Eve. This week, there's no youth group and no women's study on Wednesday because of Thanksgiving. The youth will have a Christmas party on December 12th. There's information in the bulletin about that, but it'll be a Christmas party with prizes for the ugliest and most creative sweaters. The youth are invited to bring a snack to share. I think that's all the announcements I have. This morning, we have a guest with us with Gideon's to share a little bit about that. So I invite you up at this time.
So I sat at in my closet with a gun in my hand. I was ready to end my life. Terry Hensley had hit rock bottom. She was 25 years old. She had had three kids, and she had already been divorced twice. She didn't hold a full-time job, and so life was tough. And she said, when I looked into the mirror, all I saw was a loser. So with gun in hand, in a desperate plea, I shouted out to whoever might hear. I said, God, if for some reason I should not end my life right here and right now, then you must do something. Well, right about that time, her son come running into the house and yelled, Mama, Mama, I got something at school today. And it was a New Testament that the Gideons had distributed, similar to this. So she said, I dried my eyes, dried my tears, and put my gun away and went to my son. And I went and started reading the testament with him, and it really impacted my life. She said, I don't remember what we read that day, but she said, I ended up accepting Christ as my Savior. And life did get better. In Isaiah 55:11, it's kind of a Gideon theme verse. It states, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It shall not return unto me void, but it will accomplish that which I purpose and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it. Well, the Gideons, we are professional professional business and men's association, and our sole purpose is to win men, women, boys, and girls to the Lord Jesus. Now, we are established now in 201 countries, and we provide scriptures in over 100 languages. Over 90 million scriptures were distributed in the past 12 months, and to date, since our establishment well over 100 years ago, we have placed over almost 2.5 billion scriptures throughout the world. Now, scriptures are placed in schools, and obviously many of you may be familiar with this one, the ones that you see in motels. We help assist Gideons in other countries in what we call scripture blitzes. And obviously, a lot of countries, there's Gideons there in some of these 200 countries, but they don't have the means to really distribute the amount of scriptures they need to. Well, currently, one of our local gentlemen, fellow Gideon from Brewster, Phil Knox, is actually in the country of Ghana in Africa. And Phil said there's a lot of challenges, obviously, when you do something like that. And I'm well aware of that. I was in Italy for 2 weeks in 2006, and then in 2011 I was in the West African country of Mali. And there are many, many challenges, but God is faithful. And one of the needs that we would have is for you to pray for us. Phil said they had some more scriptures coming in on an ocean vessel, and they were getting held up, and these were the scriptures they were needing this week. Starting today, he will be home the 26th. He's already been there a week. And the scriptures arrived, but I think there have been some issues in port. But they've been distributing to schools and possibly prisons. When I was in Mali, we went to a prison, and I won't elaborate, but it was not very nice. We actually go to our local jail here, try to almost every Sunday to share scriptures and share with the inmates. And this jail here is a Hilton hotel compared to some in the foreign countries that we've been in. So you say, well, what can we do? Well, we would appreciate your prayers. And obviously, if you're able to give in your bulletin today, there's an insert. It's got an envelope in it, if you care to help purchase some scriptures for less than $1.20 each. These small testaments can be placed in the hands of someone in a foreign country. That includes all the costs of printing and getting it to that country. So it's a missionary that is very, very reasonable, if you want to say that. So anyway, I appreciate being able to be here today to share with you what the Gideons are doing. And I ask that God would bless you and bless this congregation. Pastor, thank you for the time.
First, I'll turn on my mic. I invite you now to stand and greet one another this morning.
Thank you. Good morning. Would you all join me in call to worship and stand if you're able? Come, join in the work of our God. Come, join in the movement of our God.
Worship God as he in justice and peace.
Come, join in the hope of our God. Come, join in this time of worship.
Worship God,
leads us into life everlasting. Our songs of celebration will be Stand By Me in the songbook number 512 and Hymn of Promise in the same songbook 707.
Thank you.
Please be seated, and I invite the children to come up at this time.
How are you guys today? Good, good, good. I have a question. Have any of you ever had to move houses or towns before? Yeah, a couple times. We've had to move a couple times too. What did it feel like knowing that you had to move and leave your friends, move to a new house? A little sad, maybe a little scary. You move somewhere where you didn't know anyone. Yeah, it can be kind of tough sometimes. Well, Jesus was with his friends one day, his disciples, and they had just left a beautiful church, kind of like we're in church now. And as they're walking out, he's talking about it, and he tells his friends some really sad news. He says that someday this church isn't going to be here anymore, and some really bad things are going to happen in the future. How would you imagine his disciples felt? Probably some sad, probably a little scared. They may not knew all that Jesus was talking about. A little afraid of what was going to happen. Kind of like those of us that have moved, kind of the same feelings maybe that we had. But you know, what Jesus said was going to happen did happen later. But some good things also happened too. And one of the good things is, because of the bad things that happen, we get to come to church today. And we get to know about Jesus. And we get to tell other people about Jesus. And so like when we moved, we made new friends. And we got a new house. We met new people. So it can be really sad and really scary sometimes. But Jesus is always going to be with us. And he's always going to help us. And we can always pray to him. And he can come and he will comfort us during those times. Do you guys pray with me this morning? Yes. Dear Jesus, thank you for loving us and always being there to comfort us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Now is the time we in worship, we set aside a moment to worship our God through the giving of gifts. We give out of thanksgiving and joy for what God has blessed us with in our lives. We give so that Christ may be known here in this community and also to the ends of the earth. So let us give and give generously this day.